Welcome to Algeria. Algiers, the capital city of Algiers. Algeria is big. I'm here to explore next 3 days, so I hope you will like it. And if you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is AKA Muriala. We're right here to find out a little bit more information on the city. There's nothing pre-planned, but there's so much to do in the city, and I'm looking forward to explore Algeria. And the best thing to do to explore a city when you go there always is to mix the locals, and I've got two local boys who will show me around the city, and I will introduce them next. Always good to have someone local to take you around, because they know ins and outs the city. They can speak the local language and they can help filming a lot easier than your own. And this is the best guide I've ever had, and I would like to thank Aissa and Abdullah. Martis Center, this is the heart of the city, and this is where all the magic happened. Quite a new station here, and as you can see, the clock tower is right behind us. When they were digging this train station, they found it something here, and it's like where people used to live there. And they, you know, they didn't want to destroy it, so they kept it, as you can see it. And you know, probably like 100 years ago, people used to live around here. This day sell dates. It's one of the famous dates in Algeria. It is called Daklet No, and this they export internationally. So if you come here, you've got a test. So I bought this box, I'll carry the rest of the day. Let me do that, as you can see that there. So I'll test that. This place used to be a church, but now, as you can see, it's been transformed to a mosque by influence the Turkish leader Erdogan. So now we're going to go inside to find out what it looks like. And it's about to, it's a dhuhr time, so we're going to brace out the door, inshallah. And we're gonna walk around and see what we got here. With that will be, so far it's a 1,000 years old visual graffiti, some old books that has been written here over 100 years. If you've got the time, you know, come and have a look at it. At least it will give you a good knowledge. And I enjoyed it, my time here.
How is your trip here?
Oh, it's good.
In Casbah, Algiers.
Algiers. Well, I'm glad, you know, you come on board to help me, to show me around the city.
Come on, Abdullah, where are you going?
There's another brother there, just a little bit shy as well.
Yeah,
a little bit shy.
So here we are in the center of Casbah. As you saw here, the museum.
The museum
of
over there.
Calligraphy
there.
Yeah.
Well,
now we keep going to the middle of Casbah, and let's discover it.
Nearly 50,000 people called Casbah home, and it's also UNESCO heritage site. Casbah, it's heart of Algiers, and it's must visit if you're in the city, and I highly recommend. Make sure you come with someone here to show you around. You can get easily lost here. This brother gave it to me, this Algerian flag. I'm going to wear it after the game, because tonight there's going to be a big game, Somalia against Algeria. So after the game, I'll wear it, but not during the game. But thank you, bro. Yeah?
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Take care of yourself.
Yeah, cheers.
Nice one. Take care. Yeah.
Here to enjoy the view of Algiers while we're having our lunch. And this church is one of the very few left in Algiers, and it's called Notre Dame. And as you can see, the city, it looks, you know, you can see all of right here. So now I'll let you guys enjoy the view. Down one of the most dramatic looking bullet of art. It's beside the Ketchaou Mosque. You can see really all the buildings, and also you can see towers hanging all of the balconies. It is market area. Imagine how cool to leave one of those buildings.
Garden. This is a big garden here in Algiers.
It's the biggest garden.
Yeah. And, we found here a lot of types of plants.
And trees.
Yeah.
Do you know roughly how many trees are in here?
I don't remember. It's too much.
I'm assuming it's a lot.
Yeah.
We'll put
the number here.
Okay. And apparently I've heard that there's a two type of it. There's the French garden.
Yeah, the English two type. Yeah. There's English type and French type. And we'll go this.
Which one is this way? Is this the French one?
This way?
This is the
English type.
Oh, is this the English one?
Okay. English type.
So what's the difference? Is this smaller?
The style of garden.
Gardens. Mm. Oh, well.
Look at this. This big trees.
Wow. This. Everywhere you look at, there's so much trees there. I think you can spend here whole day.
All day.
Yeah, and it's very peaceful.
You can smell the smell. The natural nice.
Yeah, that's why there's a lot of kids here, you know.
Yeah.
Well, if you
because
ever
it's a holiday.
Yeah, well, is it a public holiday here today?
Yeah, it's too much noise of kids here.
Yeah.
This garden was open to the public in 1914, but later was closed during the Civil War in 1993. It was officially reopened in 2009. Arabia.
Now we are talking in Arabic, Algerian language. رانا الآن في حديقة الحامة كما راكم تشوفوا هي أكبر الحدائق هنا في الجزائر ومعروفة أنه هي حديقة تجارب اللي هنا في الجزائر حديقة تجارب ما شاء الله فيها أكثر من 1200 تقريب نوع من النباتات اللي جربوها هنا وهذه الحديقة اللي تأسست في 1832 ميلادي يعني حديقة قديمة
عامين بعد الاحتلال
أيوة. بعد الاحتلال عامين هي
عامين بعد الاحتلال
دوها هنايا وجاية في بلوزداد محمد بلوزداد
شارع محمد بلوزداد
أيوة في العناصر قالوا لها رويسو in French إيه وش تعرف الحمى أخوي عبد الله قل لهم حاجة
الحامة فيها هنا مثل الفيلم تاع طرزان
طرزان فيلم
كاين زوج انواع تاع الحدائق كان الحديقه الانجليزيه والحديقه الفرنسيه الحديقه الانجليزيه تتميز بالكثافه تاع الاشجار تاعها والممرات تاعها الضيقه والملتويه أما الحديقة الفرنسية وهي واسعة وفيها الأشجار على الجنب والمساحات الخضراء الحشائش
Algiers is in the coast of the Mediterranean. Algiers is now as the white city because all the white buildings and it makes the city cooler in those hot Mediterranean summers and I think it's a beautiful nickname. Algeria is not everyone tourism map, but I will say, if you enjoy traveling, come to Algeria, Habibi. This is the biggest mosque in Africa and third largest mosque in the world, after two holiest mosques in Mecca and Medina.
Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah.
The mosque complex included a Quran school and a library that can hold up to a million books. And also this Islamic Museum of Art, and the mosque can hold up to 120,000 worshippers at the same time. It is a beautiful place to come. I'm going to wrap up this video here. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope this gives you some sort of taste what Algeria is like, and stay tuned, more to come from Algeria.